Hello friends, welcome to PG All in One. In today's video we will discuss about table 13 in Gstr 1 return, that is document issued during tax period. Here are 12 different sections in which you need to fill detail based on your business transaction. You can click on blue button, that is add document button. Click on it to add details in it. You can enter the detail like serial number. If I suppose here enter 1 to 10, then you have to enter if any invoice is cancelled. Here I enter 0, then automatically the net value will come over. So above action, below action tool, you can see a red box like delete box, drop box. So you can click on it to delete it. If you click on it, then permission will ask, are you sure? You can click on proceed. Then you can see the data is deleted. So this way you can delete the data. Suppose if you are having two different books with two different serial numbers, then you can enter the details in next column. So you can click on add document button and enter the other book's detail. So this way you can enter different books details here. So table 13 is to be filed if you have any single transaction business. That is means if you have any sales or purchase for that particular month, then you need to file the table 13 details. You need to fill it. Suppose if you fail to fill the details in table 13, then you can provide those details in next GSTR 1 return. In every section you need to enter detail from serial number to total number of cancels and then or not issued, then automatically that will be selected. You don't need to fill every section. Means if you don't have any debit note for that current month, then you don't need to enter any data in that debit note section. So remember guys to click on save button once you enter the details online. If you fail to click on save button, the data will not be saved and you might be required to enter it again. So this is a small video on table 13 of document issued during tax period. You can also use offline utility to enter detail in the table 13. If you any payment is received, then you need to enter it in payment receipt, and then payment, or if you have made any payment, then you need to enter it in payment section. This small video on table 13. Hope guys this will help you in filling the detail in table 13. Thank you guys for watching. Please hit like button and subscribe PG All in One because it's free.